describe to us perhaps the state of our jails right now, which sparked the moves in the first place to improve these overburdened facilities?
Right now, our jails really are congested to the tune of about 330-320% congestion.
Wow. That's big.
Yeah, it's big because it was really designed to accommodate only 12,000. Now we are about 52,000. We break the number of 53,000 last week ago. So when I came in last year, it was only 48,000, and it's increasing. No, so really, it's really a difficult situation we are now undergoing.
All right. And having said that, you know, you had the recently concluded summit, which of course aims to draw out a roadmap, if you will, for jail decongestion. Tell us a bit about the recommendations that you came up with at the summit.
Yeah, the guidance is, as stated by our Chief Justice, is to limit the acceptance of those who will be incarcerated in jail, to speed up the release of those people staying in jail, and then, of course, to put up the additional facilities to accommodate those who are now undergoing a difficult time because of congestion.
Okay, we've been making progress with speeding up the release of some prisoners and minor offenders, but limit the acceptance, how does that work?
I think they are saying that if you don't have a strong case against them, those who will be charged of whatever, murder, drugs, or crimes, you don't have to charge them. And then they want to lower the bail to 10,000.
Okay.
So, because, you know, we have two jails now in the, or three jails now in the country. We have the provincial jail, those who are already incarcerated in the provinces. And then we also have the Bureau of Jail and Penology and Management. They have about 111,000 persons who are undergoing trial.
Okay.
That consists the bulk of the people who are now in jail, because even if you are not yet finally convicted and you are undergoing trial, you are put in the BGMP jail.
All right. Going back to what you brought up earlier, the third point, putting up new facilities, new jail facilities. What are you looking at under this initiative? Have you identified, or are there concrete plans already to really put up these new facilities in addition to the existing ones?
Yes, we already have the so-called land. We have the land, but unfortunately, we don't have the facilities. We have about 48,000 hectares of land, but unfortunately, our facilities are limited, because it can only accommodate about 12,000.
Okay.
So really, this year we are building new facilities, and next year, and hopefully by the end of the term of the president Marcos Jr., we already have addressed the congestion problem.
Okay, one of the major factors that would determine if this would succeed is, of course, funding. What kind of commitment did you get from stakeholders during the summit as regards funding the expansion of our jails?
Oh, we had a strong commitment from the Speaker of the House, Martin Romualdez, to support the regional prison and penal farms that we have to be constructed. And then at the same time, we have also the strong commitment of our Senate President Mick Subiri to put up the maximum, supermax prison and penal farm. So they both want to address this congestion at the same time.
All right. Now, you know, there are low-hanging fruits while we're waiting for the big move to happen. What are the low-lying or low-hanging fruits? I mean, what are the efforts currently being undertaken in our jails to at least improve the conditions while we're waiting for the big jail that is going to be constructed?
Yeah. On our part, we are now with the joint venture of the Department of Agriculture and Department of Justice. We are now putting up the prisons without walls.
Okay.
We are putting it up in Palawan, where we allow the PDLs to not to be put inside this prison cell, but stay in Nipa huts so that they can work without being incarcerated. So we call it the Barrio Libertad.
Okay.
It's a liberated barrio where those who are just about to be released will stay, and hopefully we can also bring their families with them so that they don't need to think about escaping in as much as they are with their families.
All right. As regards the new jail that will be put up, do you have an amount perhaps or a project cost, the amount of money that you need to put that up?
Yeah, for the regular prison and penal farm or the regional prison and penal farm, we are thinking it will cost us about 4 billion.
4 billion
but
pesos.
Okay. For the supermax, because they already dictated that it should be high tech.
Okay.
There's an additional cost of about 2 million. It will cost us about 6 billion.
Supermax. All right. And lastly, what are the next steps now after the summit? What's going to happen immediately as a result?
I think we will be releasing more and more PDLs in the coming months and years, in as much as we are putting a stop on the entrance of PDL, and then we are fast-tracking the releases of those who are already served or just about to finish their sentence. And then also with the assurance of Congress of money to put up the additional facilities, I think we can turn around this problem within the term of this administration and this justice sector coordinating council will be able to win over congestion and reintegration for PDLs.
All right. Lastly, sir, don't you think there is a social impact on this move, releasing more PDLs or limiting the acceptance of PDLs, especially petty criminals? Do you think this would impact peace and order situation as a result?
No. In fact, it will help in the peace and order situation because if they allow me to do the reformation, because during the seminar or the 2-day stakeholders convention, I saw that there were so many recidivists on the part of BJMP who were being released.
Okay.
So I also recommended that those who already have been sentenced will be given immediately to Bucor, because the arrangement now is if you are 3 years and lower convicted PDL, you serve your sentence in BJMP.
Okay.
But if you are 3 years plus 1 day convicted PDL, you serve your sentence in Bucor. So to make sure that if we release the PDL, they'll not go back to society and harm society, we will make sure that they are really reformed and that they will be they will be given a second chance to help our country.
All right. On that note, Corrections Chief Director General Gregorio Katapang Jr., thank you so much for joining us this afternoon for your time. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.